Buying a house is a huge task. It's even a bigger task when you don't make a lot of money. But miracles do happen. And today I'm here to tell you the six things that I did that allowed me to purchase my home making less than 30K a year. Stay tuned. Welcome back to the Good Lit Family Vlog. Today's video is gonna be a little bit different. I just feel like I need to do this. Maybe someone could get some motivation or someone could learn something from my experience. So this has been like a video that I've been wanting to do. As you guys can see from the title, I'm gonna be telling you the six things that I did to purchase my home while making less than 30K. So first and foremost, let me talk about the price. So the price of this home that I purchased with this income was surprisingly a $310,000 home. So now that we got that out of the way, let me head into the six things that allowed me to purchase my home. So the first one I had on my list is excellent credit. First, I must say that the credit helps you to get the best rate, which means that you'll pay less interest over time. Anywhere over like 700 is a good start, but to get the tip-top best rates, sometimes you have to be like maybe 730, 750 or upwards. Luckily, my credit score was closer to the 800s, so I was able to achieve one of the best rates out there. Whereas I was with the VA, which is also another benefit of me. I know that most persons, VA loans only go for like military members or maybe the spouse of a military person. But how that helped me is that I didn't pay any mortgage insurance. But there's a downside to that as well. With the VA loan, there's a funding fee. Even though over time it might equate to being less than paying mortgage insurance, but that's another cost that you have to look into. That's where it's like maybe a 70-30, 60-40 ratio. Because for instance, if you don't have the VA loan and you get like a regular conventional loan, you'll have to pay mortgage insurance. That's if you don't have that 20% down payment to make. But say that you don't have that, you'll just pay the mortgage insurance, which will equate to a little bit more than the funding fee. So it's a 50-50 there, but it took off the mortgage insurance. So as I was saying, with low income, no mortgage insurance mean lower monthly payments, which means it is easier for you to qualify with less money. My next thing is my low debt to income ratio. Making that amount of money, basically you have to have no debt. And that was my situation. I didn't have no debt. Zero credit cards, zero student loans, zero everything. I didn't have a car payment because I normally buy my vehicles cash. So I normally buy my vehicles off auction and then repair what needs to be repaired, so it's like brand new. But debt to income ratio is what is going to allow you to qualify to purchase your home. So let me rephrase that. So your debt to income ratio, that will determine how much you are qualified for. So it's not the rate, it's not really how much money you make, but what that little percentage ratio is. So for instance, if you make maybe $10,000 a month, but you have $8,000 in expenses, even though you make a lot of money, you still won't be able to qualify for a large loan so you could buy a big house or an expensive house. So with my debt to income ratio being very low, my income was able to be used just for my mortgage and whatever expenses that comes with the mortgage. So that is how me making that small amount of money made it possible for me to qualify to purchase a home like this. But it wasn't that straightforward because I didn't qualify for the full amount. And that's where your savings come in. So at this time when I was purchasing my house, I was actually doing active duty. So I thought I was gonna be able to use my active duty income. But as I was saying, there was a lot of roadblocks. I wasn't able to use that income because they said, I don't have proof that I will be in that same job like a year after I close on my house. So that went out the drain. I thought it wasn't gonna be possible because I didn't believe that I could qualify with my income. So I was like, it wasn't meant to be. But I keep going on the lenders working with me. They said I'm qualified for this amount, which was around $250 thereabout. And they said I'll just have to make the down payment. Luckily, all that time I was saving my money, so I was able to get my down payment. So that is where the saving comes in. But sometimes you know that you still need a little bit of help. So what if all of your saving is done? As I would recommend, try to borrow from someone who like lend you interest free. That's the first step to see if someone will be like friendly like that, who you could trust, maybe a parent or a good friend. Try those options before you actually go and borrow where you're gonna have to pay interest again, which might be hard because you might not qualify just because of your low income already. So I was lucky that my mom and I had a good relationship. So anywhere I fell short, she was there to back me up, but I didn't fell short that much. That was just emergency funds, just in case. But that really helped for you knowing that you have a peace of mind so that you can have less stress. So I covered 5 of the 6 tips that I had. And the last one is the most funniest, some persons might think. But it's actually the grace of God. Most times I think it was just not gonna work out. Like everything was just moving so fast at one point. Like when I first started to try and get this house, you had to make the down payment and they were like, you have to make it like in a couple of days because there's a lot of persons who are trying to get this house. So luckily I was in the area. I was in the area working, as I was saying, I was on military duty. So me and my realtor was very close. We were quick, we wrote the check, locking our position to get that lot and so that no one else can get it. And sometimes God, it just has to be destined for you. I think this was destined for me because there's a lot of things that could have gone wrong. But as I said, the grace of God was there to push me through. Because at one point I thought like, maybe they don't want to give me this house. Because there was, seem as if there was so much hiccups. Like there was always something else. So I just thought this was destined for me. And I just believe in destiny. What is to be will be. So that's basically it. It's not no rocket science or anything. You just have to be able to budget. I know it sounds all perfect and easy. I know that a lot of persons have a lot of challenges, but once you set your foundation, as I said, you can work on your credit, because I took less than maybe 3 years to get good credit because I migrated and came here in 2016. And I just learned the credit business, learned how important that it was, and then I started working on it. The only thing that is holding me down now is the age, because the age of credit is very important. I might do another video talking about credit. And as I was saying before, the VA loan is not a must. It has its pros and its cons. So you can get a regular like FHA, conventional, whatever you might qualify for. Because the VA, as I was explaining before, saves you from the mortgage insurance, but you still have to pay those funding fee. And also a low debt to income ratio. That's very important. If you can pay off all your credit cards, if you can do without a car payment, because that's a big bummer, see if you can. Because that is what gets you the amount that you need to be qualified for. What they normally look for is 40 to 50% ratio. And I don't think I've explained this before, but how they do this is like whatever they estimated your mortgage is gonna be with the property taxes and everything, all your debt, everything, you're gonna add that up and divide it by the amount of money you make. What you can provide statements for. Because everything has to be accounted for in your account. So once you divide that and times it by 100, that would give you a debt-to-income ratio. For me, I think they gave me a leeway, like maybe 50% or maybe 45%, but most persons normally want 40% debt income ratio. So that would let them know that if you have a mortgage of this size, of this amount, if you were able to manage it, so that 40%, that 60% that might would have left off, that's for an expenses that you might run into, so that they know that you won't go house broke. So the low to debt income ratio, I think that's the most important thing, other than actually having a good credit. Because without the low, the debt income ratio being right, like it's a no-go already. So viewers, I know this video is a bit different from what we normally do. You know, we always do our little challenges, our vlogs, exciting stuff. But you have to mix it up now and then. Just remember to like the video, subscribe if you're new, and keep on sharing to your friends. And maybe someone could have learned something from this, because I'm not a pro. This is just a regular person who've been through and get a little experience, like sharing what he has learned. So don't take my advice as professional advice, but someone who just went through it and just think that it's just amazing how he was able to do it. So that is it for today, guys. Remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And remember, CG the genius, nothing but greatness. We out.